her sister Carol. Mm-hmm. And that was tragic. Young woman with children. I just want to know what happened during that time for you. What did it make you think? What were you evaluating about your own life when you lose a family member like that?
I mean, I think that was the first time in life that I had really taken a step back and realized that fame and everything is great. Without your family, without health, what do you have? Mm-hmm. Money can't buy that. Money can't bring my sister back to me, you know? And, I mean, I remember that first year, it was very hard because it was even harder to see my mom go through the mourn mm-hmm. of a whole year of just being sad. I mean, wearing black. You hear about that kind of stuff in the movies and you hear about that, but to actually see your own mother go through that grief, you know, I learned that I took a negative thing and realized I have to turn it into a positive thing. And I had to take a step back and realize if God had to choose a family for this to happen to.
Now we were really heavy. We talked about all the decent, but do you realize that everything that you have just said, all of you, all your life experiences, that this, what happened to you all might have been now truly a blessing because it's brought you to where you are today?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, we wouldn't change anything that's happened to us in the past because, like AJ said, everything happens for a reason. Mm-hmm. We feel like that we're on the path that we're supposed to be on, and what will be.
We're still learning every day.
And also be experienced apart from one another. I think we value each other's company more. Mm-hmm. We value our relationships more. We value our family more.
Respect one another.
And we respect one another. Like you mentioned, I was joking around thinking about Nick being 25. He spent more than half of his life in the group, and to go from 12 years old to 25 and like do the solo thing that he did, the solo record and the solo tour, he got to experience life completely on his own. Mm-hmm. And like when we got back in the studio, his eyes were like this big because he was like so excited to, it was almost like he enjoyed the camaraderie and the joy and all the heartache and all the great things that have come out of sharing our lives together and feeding off of that.
And you know Canada is waiting impatiently for you guys. We've always loved you from day one.
We know
the moment you opened your mouths. You're good guys, and I wish you everything that your heart desires. And now, after I said all that sweet stuff, you gotta sing a song. I heard you sing for my competition. What's going on?
We gotta change
battery. How much time we got for that battery goes? We got 20 seconds.
Sing me a song.
Come on.
Can you?
That's my intro.
Here's
a song called "Can You See Me."
No, we're fried, dog.
It's a new record.
It's a new record.
Same place.
2, 3.
Can you see me? Here I am. Where I've always been. And when words are not enough, I come inside your heart and still find
your mind.
You're my safest place to